An American aircraft is in deep there. An American aircraft is in deep there. What is that? What is that? Who is that? Where is he from? Explain, somebody, please. You know, I was sat there playing Call of Duty World War II the other day, and my daughter, she's 9 years old, she cracked me up. She absolutely cracked me up. The recon plane in World War II is so spammed, because most of the time it's generally the only streak that people can actually reach before they get killed. You know, if I'd set it as one of my classes, which I don't have it anymore, I'm sure I would get one or two or three every game. And people have this thing about calling them in at the same time, obviously because they want to get the points up to progress onto the next streak. So you'll get sometimes it continuously. An American aircraft is in deep there. An American aircraft is in deep there. One after the other, after the other, after the other. And she started doing this impression. And I was kind of going to work the other day, and I don't know why, I was just thinking about my evening's experience playing Call of Duty, and I started doing that impression to myself in the car, just for my own bit of amusement, because my radio's broke in my car. And I was thinking about like all the great voice actors we've had over the years. I've said before in a commentary ages ago, one of my favourite characters in Call of Duty was in Modern Warfare and Modern Warfare 2, and it was Ghost. And my fascination with Ghost was almost to the brink of being a little bit nerdy, where I started reading up about him, about his whole character and what made him the way he was, what made him the kind of killer that he was. And, you know, it was to the point where in Modern Warfare 2, when he gets killed, if you guys remember playing the campaign in Modern Warfare 2, he gets poured petrol on by that guy and they throws his cigar on him and burns him alive. And I was gutted when that happened because I loved Ghost. Voiced by the brilliant Craig Fairbrass, always plays a horrible piece of work in Rise of the Foot Soldiers. This one scene where he phones up for a pizza, the guy on the end of the phone annoys him, so he heads off to the pizza joint, grabs hold of this kid, puts his hand around his throat, gets his head on the counter, gets the pizza cutter and slices it across his face. It's a brutal scene that makes you go, ooh, ouch. But that's Craig Fairbrass, that's the kind of character he plays. And you think, all these great characters, Soap, Captain Price, Ghost, you know, brilliant voice actors. And it's like Call of Duty over the sort of series and over the years, it's almost like they've budgeted that much on their voice actors that they've ended up with this man, who wherever he's from, what part of Cape Town this person is from, I don't know. An American aircraft is in the air. I mean, what accent is that? Is that supposed to be a German accent? I haven't played campaign, so I don't know if there's a backstory to where this guy's from or what he's doing, or whether he's a South African posing as a German. But that is not a German accent. If that's supposed to be a German accent, that is the worst voice acting I've ever heard in my life. And I was sort of sitting there thinking, what process do they go through to employ these people? What kind of recruitment process do they go through to get these people in to be these voice actors? And how did this guy slip through the net? They must have literally just had three people sitting at a desk and somebody said, okay, guys, listen up. We've got 150 of the finest recommended voice actors coming in today and they're going to play the part of the announcer. Now, John, I want you to make notes. They're all listed, 1 to 150. I want you to make notes of their number. And at the end, we're going to sit down. We're going to have a little think about it, put our heads together, crack some skulls, and we're going to find the best one to play the announcer. He's got to have a strong German accent, though. So are we all ready? Yeah? Everybody got a tea? Everybody got a drink? Got your biscuits all sorted? Ready? Okay. Thinking heads on, guys. Let's crack on. And they must have literally sat there, got through this whole 150 people, and then turned around at the end and gone, right, okay, whew, that was a long day. A long, hard day. I'm bored and tired and I literally need to go home and have a drink. So what do we think? Anybody? What number do you recommend, John? I don't know. I just listed the numbers down. Did you not put a tick next to any? You've literally just wrote the numbers down. Well, no, you just said write the numbers. Yeah, write the numbers, but put something next to it. A comment. He was good. Great German accent. Anything. Anything, John. Give me something. Oh, my God. Oh my God, we've got to meet with Condry in 20 minutes and we've got to have a decision made on an actor. Guys, come on, think. How are we going to get out of this? Well, I've got an idea. It's a bit maverick, but why don't we just pull a number out the bag and wish for the best? That is the worst idea I've ever heard, but it might just work. Okay, right, so think of a number. Quick, guy, anybody, just get a number. 21, okay, 21 it is, right, brilliant. Call him back. So Mr. Number 21 must have literally thought all his Christmases had come at once because he's failed every audition leading up to this one. And now he's hit the big time. He's on what, Call of Duty World War II, Activision. Oh my God. His wife said he'd never make it as a voice actor. I'll show her. Come in and they're recording. Right, okay, how are you doing? Yes, yes, we remember you. You were very good. We want you to read these lines, but when you start off with this one, because it's going to be the most popular kill streak, and it's enemy recon aircraft is in the air, and we want you to do it in your best German accent, okay? Everybody ready? Yeah, you ready with the record button? Brilliant. 3, 2, 1, action. Enemy recon aircraft is in the air. What was that? That's my best German accent. That's not German. That's South African. That's Cape Town. He's not South African. He's German accent. Come on, go for it again. Take two. That was the only take. That's it. One take. That's all we've got. We need more. One. That's it. Oh, my God. I've got a meeting with Condry tomorrow. He's going to kill me. He's going to have that angry look on his face that looks like Will Ferrell having a poo. I can't deal with this. I just can't deal with this. Hopefully, we'll get away with this. We'll wing it, but my job's on the line. You know what? If I'm going down, you lot are coming with me. I don't want to lose my position here at Sledgehammer, the finest game developer on Earth. Oh, man. Oh, it's just ridiculous. I had to share that with you because it was bugging. It's bugging me. I've now got to the point now where I've actually muted the announcer. I can't listen to it. I don't know what plethora of surprises I'm going to get when I'm playing. You know, maybe there's a recon aircraft up. I don't know. You know, this guy come around the corner and know where I am. I couldn't tell you. Maybe a bomb's going to drop on my head and I don't get the warning. I just hear the noise. I've just got to automatically assume that bad things are going to happen because I can't listen to him saying, enemy recon aircraft is in deep air. Thanks for watching, guys. Probably the most pointless commentary you will ever witness this year, but hey, I'll see you on the next one.